This one is confidence. Confidence. That's what they say. Commitment to what? No, commitment to disappointment. Commitment in this, commitment in disappointment. Now this one is confidence in danger. Now read verse 11.
Then Jephthah went with the elders of Gilead.
He went with the elders, he went. Yes?
And the people made him head.
He first of all took back his kingship. Are you getting me? Immediately Jephthah went back, these were the people that threw him out. It means when the father died, the next person that was supposed to be in charge was Jephthah. But because the people could not destroy him, they cannot kill him, he was stronger than them, they dug his past and used his past against him. Say your mother was a prostitute, they casted him out. Now they needed him because there's no way. God's prosperity, the foundation is peace and protection. So if you don't have peace and you don't have protection, yes, you will never prosper. Because God has to guide the one you have already gathered. Otherwise, because every time prophet and loss, you will never make prosper. I get what I'm saying. So a time came when they needed peace. They wanted to control the peace they have, but no protection. They needed somebody to come and offer that protection. And Jephthah was the person. So they came to Jephthah and said, Jephthah, please help us. This is our problem now. We have this peace, our father's inheritance, but we don't have protection. Some people are coming to take it away from us. But you are our own. You are in fact the leader. Come on. And Jephthah came and said, first of all, give me back the leader. Make me your king first. Make me your leader. He has forgiven, but he didn't lose his kingship. Don't be so stupid. When people deal with you and insult you, and when they say forgive, and not make a way so that that thing will not repeat again. That was what Jephthah did. So that they will not insult. You can't tell me when they insulted you, didn't offend you. It pained you, but you are trying now to turn the pain into gain. You are trying now not to allow the pain to become a hurt. So you have to be wise. Let me tell you something. If you are passing through a road and a dog bites you the first time, people will say, sorry, but if you are passing the same road again and the same dog beat you, people will say you are foolish. Yeah. You are very, very stupid. The same people that say, you pass the road and the same dog beat you. That dog, you know, the dog teeth is like this. Yeah. And he's always looking for somebody to bite. Hey! It was out of ignorance. He didn't know. You will see, they will send you to hospital. Pay your bill. But if you pass the same road again, the same dog beat you, and you come, hey, they will kick you and say, that dog will kill you, you are a stupid man. That was what Jephthah avoided. I passed this road before. I will not say, give me my kingship first. Don't be too stupid as a Christian and allow this to keep on happening in your life. The first time the big dog beat that man, they say that dog is man. The second time they now say the man is man. Does that make sense? The first time the dog beat the man, they say the dog is man. The second time the dog beat the man, they now say the man is man. I'm trying to make 3 points from this one verse. Jephthah said, go. I need my kingship first. Remember our topic. Confidence in danger. He's piling up something. He's taking a risk. Jephthah is taking a risk. He has not yet won the battle. But he said, make me your leader first. And they went. Where did they make him his leader? The leader. Great.
And the people made him head.
Uh-huh.
And captain over them.
Uh-huh.
And Jephthah uttered all his words before the Lord, his inmeasurable wisdom.
The same people that insulted him, the same people that called him them, he's now their leader. Power has changed him. The Bible says it was like a dream. Says it was like a dream for the captivity of Israel to come. It was the elders. They went before the Lord, number two, they went before the Lord and entered into covenant and said, you are now our leader. It can never be broken again forever. Now, what was the lesson? Can somebody get it for me? Can somebody preach for me? Yes. And this is why he has confidence in danger. In the same verse, there are 3 things I told you happened there. One, Jephthah took back his king. The people went before the Lord and made him elder and agreed with God. Then what was the third thing? Read it now. It's there in the Bible. Preach it for me. Anybody?
Is it verse 12?
The same verse. 3 things happened here. Jephthah went with the elders. They gave him back his kingship. And they went before the Lord and agreed with David, with God, with him before the Lord. There was an agreement. Number one, the third thing. The last statement there, read it.
And Jephthah uttered all his words before the Lord in Mizpah.
What does that mean? What happened? Can you explain the character, this attribute? Why? What was his confidence in danger?
God
is his confidence. Look at what he did. Now think about it. Let's just use our let's brainstorm our brain. If you lost your kinship like Jephthah, and you know it's too important, and you know that's the only reason God created you, but you can't fight your own people. Samson, it happened to Samson. When the Philippians wanted to kill him, he said, "Don't touch me, my brothers. You have the power to kill me. But leave me with the people God has created me to fight and stuff. They are not a problem." And Jephthah got back his kingship. Remember, there is this great battle before you. What would you have done? If you get back your kingship, what would you do? In the same verse, I'm looking at it. It's one of his attributes.
The prayer.
Prayer, okay? It's not just prayer. Have you not seen something about this man in this verse? His confidence is danger. This is a sign of born again. He has no lack. Immediately he got the kingship, the first place he ran to before God. Immediately he got back. He said, "God, you created, this was the reason you called me. For the past 20 years, they took this away from me. They have lied against me. They have conspired against me." Now, just take example. Listen now. There's a challenge. Let's say with Church of Commission. And practically tomorrow, and God put it in my hand to solve that problem. And the first thing they did, that they said, the DA said, or the person in charge of us said, "Why are we wasting our time? Have you not been seeing Idiga? Is he not our son? You see him with the prime minister every time. You see him all over the world. You see him, God, you see him doing great things. This guy, you did only one finger, he will solve this problem for us. Why are we still delaying? Why can't we humble ourselves? Why? Have you not seen him? If he wasn't in love, if he wasn't concentrated on church commission, he would have broken away. But upon all he has passed through, but upon all the insults, but upon all the conspiracy, but upon everything, he's still carrying the flag of church commission. Why are we still waiting?" And one of them will say, I know him, let me just get his number and call him. Hello, Idika. He said, "What is it?" This approval, this, that. Okay, my friend is in charge. We can do it. Pa. I'll call him now. Pam. Nearly he did that. Do you know what? He went back to God and said, "Lord, can I ever thank you for giving me an opportunity to serve my brothers again? Can I ever appreciate you enough to continue from what my father shouted from me? Are you getting what I'm saying?" But I'm already somebody that is proud of living in himself. Ustad, this is what I'm going to do with you. I will show you better. You know your. He said, no, no, no. You are still in charge. You are still in charge of this. You are still. What? You are the head. What is your role? No, it's not. My call is to make sure you're happy. And I see you like this. And I see you like that. And I say, what? Jephthah only doesn't take. Jephthah, the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 19, if your hope is serving Christ, all your hope is what you get on earth. You see, you are of all men most miserable. Jephthah had no intention of getting anything from this. There's no nothing. Immediately he got back. He went back to God and said, God, what next? His confidence in danger. That was his confidence. Remember, he was going to face danger. But the only confidence he had was in God. Jephthah was saying, God, even as you have told me that I'm supposed to continue from where my father stopped, now that my people have taken it away, you didn't call me to kill them. I am ready, whatever you want me to do. God said, wait. I shall overcome. And I shall overcome the third time. After the third time, that which belongs to you shall come back to you. And when it happened, Jephthah did not have gotten it. He went back. Ramaha Shandalaba. Ilaba Baba. This did not happen because I'm Jephthah. This did not happen because I'm strong. This never happened because I'm here. Leya handa handaya. What next, Lord? What next? Without you, I'm going nowhere. Without you, I will fail. Without you, I will die. Immediately. He didn't seek any advice. He didn't even do any party. I have regained my kingdom. Let's go and pack. It means he was waiting. And saying, God, when are you going to do this? When are you going to finish it? And when God did it, he went back to God. Because why? He is the Alpha and the Omega. He was the one that began it. He's the one that will finish it. Jephthah relied 100% on God. His confidence in danger was Jehovah. And look at what happened. After he has finished. So prayer was not a last resort for Jephthah. Prayer was what? The first thing and everything. Jesus started with prayer. Ended with prayer. See some people that are great. They don't make do any longer with prayers. Prayer doesn't mean anything any longer to them. Because they are mighty men. But this man, his mightiness is from the Lord. It's not by mind, not by power, but by the Spirit of the Lord. Have you got to that? Now this was why he was unshakable. The Bible says, those things that cannot be shaken. What do you mean? Those things that cannot be shaken. Can you read Hebrews chapter 12, verse 27, please? Don't close that place, yes? Yes, verse 27.
In this word, yet once more, signify the moving of those things that are shaken, as of things that are made, and that those things which cannot be shaken may remain.
You see now, church, are you getting it now? If you cannot be shaken, you remain. It's only those things that are be shaken that will not remain. Continue now, start to go back to the see what happened. Jephthah did not consult any man, Jephthah had allies. You know what it means, allies? Allies. Yeah, it should be allies, the pronunciation, but I know what I'm talking about. You know what I mean? Like America, Australia is one of their allies, whether alias or alias. Englishman, what is it? Is it what they call Australia is one of America's allies. How do you pronounce it in Australia?
Yeah, allies.
Allies. You see, listen to him. Can you say it again so that we learn? Yes, it's one of the allies. Whatever they are doing, they are lying together to do it. You always come together. Don't mind my Nigerian English in pronouncing it. Thank God you know the meaning. Allies, you know. Don't mind Nigerian English, you know. So Jephthah had many. But he never went to them, he went to God first. And look at what happened when he now went to one of his allies. Come, please.
Jephthah sent messengers unto the king of the children of Ammon,
mm-hmm.
saying,
mm-hmm.
What hast thou to do with me,
mm-hmm.
that thou art come against me to fight in my land?
Mm-hmm.
And the king of the children of Ammon answered unto the messenger mm-hmm. of Jephthah,
yeah.
Because Israel took away my land when they came up out of Egypt,
okay.
from Aaron even unto Jebel,
okay.
and unto Jordan.
Okay.
Now therefore restore those men again peacefully.
This was the inheritance of the father of Jephthah. These people came to take it. Continue.
And Jephthah sent messengers again unto the king of the children of Ammon,
mm-hmm.
and said unto him,
yes.
Thou sayest, Jephthah, Israel took not away the land of Moab, nor the land of the children of Ammon. But when Israel came up from Egypt and walked through the wilderness unto the Red Sea and came to Kadesh, then Israel sent messengers unto the king of Edom.
Now listen, now he's talking to his allies. Now listen, now I have a lot to explain in his interaction with the king of Ammon, who was coming against him. Now Jephthah was well read. He knew he wasn't just among those pastors that were motivational teachers. They will tell you what is in the Bible, they will not tell you how to achieve it. They will tell you, they only read the Bible for you. Oh, have you seen? David became the king. You can become the king. I prophesy, become the king. I prophesy. Motivational speakers. What were the things David did? You knew that David was not interested in that case. If you really go back, he's explained in Psalms chapter 78, from verse 70 to 72. You knew that David was not. What happened? He was looking after his father's. He was keeping that which was little. And then God saw his heart in keeping that which was little and gave him now the bigger one. And said, the way he's looking after his father's sheep, the way he's interested, even when I offered him to be a king, to leave the sheep, he was not interested. They anointed him to be king. And when they finished, he said, what is this? He said, it's oil and it means you are a king now. He said, have you finished? He used his handkerchief and wiped the oil. And said, I'm going back to my sheep. And God said, go out to the king, to the palace. He said, I'm not coming. God now has to make King Saul man to bring David. Even when David came, Saul wanted to kill me. He said, I told you, God, that don't belong here. It was God that was forcing him to become the king. And when motivational speakers want to tell you, don't you know you are the David of your generation? Just jump into the king, guy. Jump. You have to kill Goliath. You have to be faithful with your father's sheep first. You have to kill bear. Kill lion. Before you sit on that sheep. That's what we do here. That's what I learned from my father, Bishop Preston Alsa. He doesn't just tell you what is in the Bible. He tells you how to achieve it. He explains to you why the reason why he's there. He explains to you everything. So Jephthah was right. He said, what you're talking about belongs to us. We never took your land. And because the gathering is not of God, we shall not stop. His confidence in danger. He didn't shake. He didn't mismatch. He sent word to them. I said, why are you coming to take our inheritance? They said it belonged to us. He said it didn't belong to you. It's our father's inheritance. And that's why God created me. That's why God blessed me. And when Jephthah finished, he sent a message to his allies, Edom, and said, come, bring it, let's read that and conclude.
Then they went along through the wilderness.
No, wait, it fast. It starts from 17. Start from the beginning of that.
Then Israel sent messengers unto the king of Edom,
mm-hmm.
saying, let me, I pray thee, pass through the thy land. But the king of Edom would not hearken unto therefore.
Mm-hmm.
And in like manner, they sent unto the king of Moab, but he would not consent. And Israel abode in Kadesh.
all their allies, because Ammon was terrible. Ammon was the one in charge. They were like, you know, the world, you know, the people that were ruling the world. Continue. You continue.
Then they went along through the wilderness and compassed the land of Edom and the land of Moab and pitched on the other side of Aaron, Arnon, but came not within the border of Moab. For Arnon was the border of Moab.
Okay.
And Israel sent messengers unto Shinon, king of the Amorites, the king of Heshbon. And Israel said unto him,
can we pass through?
Let us pass, we pray thee, through thy land into my place. And Shion trusted not Israel to pass through his coast. But Shion gathered all his people together and pitched in Jahaz and fought against Israel.
And fought against Jephthah. Jephthah was going to fight his enemy. He wanted to move with his allies. Whatever. They all disappointed him. Because of the terror of the con of Ammon, they rejected even one of them became against Jephthah. If the Ammon had that he passed through my land, if they had that he agreed with you when you are coming to fight him, they will come out. This would have made Jephthah to give up. This would have made there are so many things you don't know about Jephthah. There are some, Jephthah knew when deep is calling on to deep. He knows what to do. He knows that you don't need to. Jephthah knew. No, he said, this is not another fight. This is not another, all my.